Y'all, please send help. Ryan had not seen this Donald Trump jam yet, so I showed it to him. And it is currently stuck in my fucking head. I don't know if you guys have seen this yet, but it's fucking frightening. I'll give you a sneak peek. Holy fuck. But the problem is, it's stuck in my head. I'm just sitting here going, America! Help me.
Pleasantly surprised by the dry job my hair did, even though I went to bed with it super, super wet. Sometimes you can wake up and it can be like all stuck like that. But you know what? You can see how curly curls my like under hairs are. Anyways, but I'm gonna straighten this out. I should do one of those get ready with me how I do my hair vids, because now I've changed. I've moved away from the conical wand and I do the curling with the straightener thing now, which is such a hard thing to master and you burn yourself so much. But I think I'm also going to do just like a get ready with me video this weekend and get back into the like random topic videos as well, and not just like, hey, this is what I'm doing. I mean, these are so easy to make. Like, this is why I really like making these weekend reviews, because I could edit them all in one night and like collect the footage over the day. Now with these memory cards and the da 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 da, it imports, exports so quickly. The only thing I'm having problems with is that fucking iMovie situation, which ends up taking a day. So sometimes if I'm gonna try to always post these ones like a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Sunday situation for the weeks, but I might end up putting it back later if, you know, technical problems. I'm leaving for work and I peer over and I just see this little guy wrapped up in a bundle. You're like a little wizard. Looks like you're wearing a hoodie. So cute, Dexy.
Context. Tiny little gremlin.
Hey YouTube, what are you up to? I'm coming to the end of my shift in the shop and I'm excited for the comedy show that we're going to tonight. It's competitive erotic fan fiction, which is where the comedians have to write an impromptu erotic fan fiction about a topic the audience submits and then gets chosen. And then while those people are backstage writing theirs, some comedians perform pre-prepared ones. So it's like, it goes that you show up, you put some topics in a hat, you get introduced, this is what this thing is, have you guys ever heard of it, blah, blah, blah. Comedians will come on stage, they'll get their topics, the topics get picked, they leave to go write, they have half an hour write, other comedians come on stage, do the performance, then they leave. The impromptu ones are prepared. Sometimes they're even funnier than the ones people had time to write and like spent weeks and weeks on. And it's so good. It's probably like my favorite Sketchfest show. I think this is the third year that Ryan and I have gone. So Sketchfest, I don't know if I've explained this yet, but it's when there's like an entire month of just a ton of comedy shows throughout San Francisco. So it's great, so many amazing comics come. There's tribute things. We're really upset that we couldn't get tickets to the tribute to Bob's Burgers. We tried and they sold out in like 30 seconds. It was terrible. But we're going to ASCAT and this thing called, I mean, you'll hear about it when I go to them because apparently I'm vlogging now. But anyways, we absolutely love competitive erotic fan fiction. There's a podcast as well. For some reason, we haven't listened to the podcast, even though we love it so much, which is weird. I should probably listen to the podcast because we're just always like, oh yes, the show's coming. And so we're going tonight with Jen and Haley. We're gonna go out to dinner soon too. Why am I telling you this when I could just show it to you later? Maybe I'll edit this part out, maybe I won't.
I'm good at it. Like, watch.
No, yeah, but her recording, yeah.
As soon as she starts recording me.
No, that's the worst part.
That's actually better, right?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank
you. How do you say water?
I have to put it in my mouth.
Thank you, guys.
I would like some more water.
Nice, some more water. Let's get some water.
Water.
You got the camera out? I want you to show.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there you go. Thank you. It's just one card, don't worry.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
It's something I do.
Oh, yeah.
I like to.
Ryan wants you guys to know that he just bought our dinner.
I'm not like a hero. I'm not like a hero or anything, but. Yeah. I wouldn't use the word hero. Yeah. Other people.
Yeah.
It's horrible lighting. It's bad for my skin, which is what's in it.
Shit's getting weird. It is like 2:58 in the morning, and I'm doing a deep dive on nail tutorials. I have absolutely zero interest in nail art, like on myself, but it's so ASMR-y and I'm in the mood just to watch people delicately put shit on their nails. And Dexter's in the background drinking water in case you hear that and you're like, are you on the toilet? I mean, I'm also on the toilet, but no.
Oh, I've got the rumbles and my tumbles. 5:30 in the morning last night, I woke up. Shite my brains out. So I guess eating all those donuts at Bob's was not a good idea. Dexter's not ready for today yet.
No, not today.
So yeah, I'll admit, it still looks a lot like Uncle Fester. I'm just in a bad mood today. I think I'm PMSing. Ryan, can you vouch for my bad mood?
I can confirm the bad mood. Not the PMS. I don't know you that well.
You don't know me that well?
I don't know your cycle.
You should know my cycle.
Well, we do sync up, so.
I have an alpha cycle. Whenever people are with me, they get drawn into it.
Is that a thing?
Yeah. I have like the
if you went into like super a prison, you'd like change everyone's shit.
Haley, I fuck up her period every time we hang out.
Alien beta ass.
Yeah, I literally, like, sometimes I sign emails like XOXO alpha. Don't hang out with me.
Sense.
Our Uber's here. We're going to a comedy show. Hopefully that brings me out of the dredges of my mood.
The lighting makes me look like evil.
You are evil. You put a glass of wine in a girl and she's instantly in a better mood. So we're gonna go over to Vesuvio and have another drink. We don't wanna go home yet. It's only like 9 o'clock.
Don't look into the viewfinder. That's a very like amateur mood.
I'm not. The entire time I'm making eye contact directly with the lens even though I so desperately wanna see my own face.
All right, let's go.
No, we're gonna stand here for 30 more seconds.
I feel awkward.
One.
People walking
one,
by.
Two.
There's so many weird.
Three. Four. 29. 30. True story, went to that strip club once, saw a girl from high school strip at it. Or she actually cried and didn't go on stage. It was awkward as fuck. New development in the lobby saga. This book is now located here and the note is missing. I'm wondering if someone had taken this book, someone got pissed and put the note, no, 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 do not remove, AKA bring me back my bridge book. I'm on to something. I think that was what the note was about. So Ryan and I went into City Lights and we decided that we were each gonna pick out a book, AKA I decided, I was like, this is what we're doing. We each picked out a book for ourselves and then pick out a book that we were gonna read together, AKA I read to him, which is like this weird new thing that we're into. I picked up Mr. Peanut by Adam Ross because it was number one, a staff pick and I'm a sheep. And then number two, because it said like murder and marriage and mystery. So those are the three M's that I'm like, yes, 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 when I see them in a book. Ryan picked for himself The Bus Driver Who Wanted to Be God because he likes weird titles. And I think they said it was like dark and witty. So he's like, I like that. That's my laundry there that Well, that's my big pile of, don't look at that. That's my big pile of underwear I need to put away. It's clean. Don't worry. And then for us together, we picked Marin July's The First Bad Man because you can't help but love a weird Miranda July book.
Holy crap. The glitter is going in the gap. And stars. I'm like seriously amazed right now. Oh my god. What? It's gonna be like a fucking aquarium nail.
I'm fully obsessed with Simply Nailogical. She is so, so funny. You guys should watch it. By the way, it's 3:43 in the morning. Fuck.
At this point, you guys are 100% accurate if you believe that I fully subsist on Grubhub, because I do. And I'm pissed because they just delivered me my glazed teriyaki with no chicken gyoza. That's my favorite part. I scarfed that real fast though because Ryan's picking me up in an Uber and we're going to an improv show again. Sketchfest, comedy shows every night. Yes, must close down now. No one's here. Ryan and Kelsey and I went to the Facebook improv show for Sketchfest tonight. It was great. But let me just say, anyone who volunteers, raises their hand, pretty much wants to talk to the comedians during the show is generally awful. Like, they're just attention whores. And it's annoying because, you know, the people who really have, like, the funniest things probably, like, sitting there, they don't say anything because they don't fucking need the attention. They have people volunteer like interesting fun facts about themselves and then they end up picking somebody and they go through the person's Facebook Facebook page and then the improv set is kind of based on the conversation that they have on stage with the comedian. And literally one girl had the gall to raise her hand and say, I like to travel the world and go snorkeling and scuba diving with sharks and stingrays. And like she thought that was something that was interesting and unique to her. Meanwhile, there was another woman who I feel like she was pretty normal, but just had to blow everybody else out of the water because she was like, these people are all saying dumb shit. She raises her hand, Ted Bundy tried to murder my mom. Like, that's the most interesting fucking thing that anyone said that night. And how she didn't get brought up on stage to talk about this further is beyond me, and it's upsetting. I met my husband while writing an iBook about online dating, and I was dating someone else at the time. It's so annoying, but they ended up picking that girl, and she was probably the worst human. Not the worst human, because some people commit genocide and things, but she was pretty awful. And if you happen to be at that Facebook improv show on Sunday, January 17th in San Francisco, then you know what I'm talking about. That girl sucked. But let's see, some interesting ones. One guy had a master's in puppetry. Interesting. Ryan and I were talking about what our things would be if we had to give them. We don't want to raise our hands and volunteer this information. Then I figured out that mine would eventually, I guess, be that I got fourth place in a Kylie Jenner lookalike contest because all the other things that have happened to my life are sad. And Ryan's would be that his grandpa was the arresting officer on Son of Sam. So that's pretty fucking interesting.
I'm pretty sure it's not
true. Ryan doesn't think it actually was true, but they don't have to know that. And Dexter's would be I throw up every time I drink water.